the Lord, we can be awakened from these issues. So we pray today that even as we look into your word, Lord, that your spirit shall speak to us, that your words will come to us, Lord, in the power of the Holy Ghost, that we are not going to walk out of this door the same way we came in, oh Lord, because you are us. You are here for us, King of all glory. And it doesn't matter how we came in here today. It doesn't matter what situation we have been going through. It doesn't matter how much we have cried. Jehovah God, we know that today there is a loving God. A God that can awaken chords that were broken. That can vibrate one more time. So we bless you. That's why we ask you, Lord. Rescue the pain, care for the dying. Jesus is merciful. Jesus will save. Come on, somebody, just celebrate the Lord in the name of Jesus. God bless you. God bless you, good people. In the name of Jesus, let's turn to the book of 2 Kings, chapter 7. 2 Kings, chapter 7. Chapter 7, I will read from verse 3. Your breakdown point is your breakthrough point. Now there were four men who were lepers at the entrance to the gate, and they said to one another, "Why are we sitting here until we die? If we say, let us enter the city, the famine is in the city and we shall die there. And if we sit here, we die also. So now come, let us go over to the camp. We shall but die." So they arose at twilight to go to the camp of the Syrians. But when they came to the edge of the camp of the Syrians, behold, there was no one there. And of horses, behold, the king of Israel has hired against us the kings of the Hittites and the kings of Egypt to come against us. So they fled in the twilight and abandoned their tents, their horses, their donkeys, leaving the camp as it was, and fled for their lives. And when these lepers came to tent and hid them, then they came back and entered another tent and carried off things from it and went and hid them. Then they said to one another, "We are not doing right. This day is a day of good news. If we are silent and wait until the morning light, punishment will overtake us. Now, therefore, come, let us go and tell the kings." Came and called to the gatekeepers of the city and told them, "We came to the camp of the Syrians, and behold, there was no one to be seen or heard there. Nothing but the horses tied and the donkeys tied and the tents as they were." Then the gatekeepers called out, and it was told within the king's household. Praise the name of the Lord. I want to share with us this text today, which shall speak to us about our breakdown points, which should be our breakthrough points. It talks about four Samaritan men, Samaria, and Samaria was a gated city. It was a closely shut city. And according to the Bible, leprosy was one of the dreaded diseases. Actually, in the entire Bible, there are only seven men that had leprosy, apart from the 10 men that Jesus also healed. So that's a number like 8 or a number of people. Now, leprosy is used in the Bible because of its dread to be compared with person. Just how, that's how actually sin can affect a human being. So there are formal law. They cannot mingle with people. They cannot stay with their children if they had. They cannot stay with their parents. They cannot stay with their brothers and sisters. They had to stay outside, according to the book of Numbers chapter 5 and verse 2. The Bible says that this is the command. Anybody who has a skin disease has to stay outside of unclean. They were not supposed to come nearby. And the Bible tells us in the book of Leviticus, chapter number 13, verses 45 and 46, that these people who had leprosy, they had to walk away, far away, actually about 150 meters from those who had no leprosy. And they were supposed to walk in tattered clothing, and every time they saw anybody coming towards their direction, they had to shout. Unclean would definitely know that that person had leprosy. I want you to understand what kind of a situation these people were going through. Now imagine shouting unclean for the rest of your life, because they only had two options. They would either be healed or they would die. People was when they had been, a priest had certified that they had been healed and a sacrifice had been offered on their behalf. Then the priest had to come and declare to people, the so and so that you knew in this village that had leprosy has now been healed. Actually, it would take a miracle for somebody to be healed of such a disease, because it had no cure. So there were people that if they were born with leprosy, they had to stay in that state from childhood until death, if at all they would survive the cold environment and every other thing that would fall on them outside the cities. So they would stay outside the city gate. They were not supposed to come, that such a man had defiled the rest of the people, and therefore their punishment was by stoning. Hallelujah, church. So there were a people that were downtrodden in the society. There were a people that people looked down upon. There were people that were rejected. There were people that were despised. Imagine having parents, but you cannot stay near them except if both you and your parent are leprous. If you and your brother are leprous, now they had a community of leprous people. So these were people who think that they were waiting for was that people would come and help them. Actually, people were eating and throwing the remains of food to them outside the city because they were not supposed to get near them. They would eat to them and then they would take whatever had remained and throw to them outside the city. So there were people who lived their entire lives shouting that they were clean, begging for food, living in the cold, and every other thing that could happen to them was fortunate. And nobody cared. Inside, just inside the city gates, there was a council of elders that used to sit somewhere there to do some judicial issues and religious issues. They were not supposed to participate in any of those things. So there were people who were crushed in their hearts. There were people who were really troubled in their lives. There were people who were going through a lot of things that were happening to sin. They have faced famine for 3 good years. The prophet of the Lord, Elisha, had prophesied that because of their sinfulness, they were going to suffer famine for 3 good years. And they were just coming at a time when the famine was just about to be over. But listen to this. There was one more trouble. Outside the city gates, there were the Aramean strategy of war that enemies would use. They would surround the city gates so that nobody would go. Famine, we have people who are now facing their own uncleanness, unclean situation. We have people who are now facing the enemy surrounding Israel. And therefore, the enemy surrounded them and waited until there was no more food in the city. They were waiting for the enemy inside to eat everything that they had gathered. So that after they had eaten every Samaria, they have eaten everything that they had until there was no more food left. And therefore, everybody in the city was left to die. And everybody outside the city was left to die. Because outside, there was a swearing without energy, without food, and then they would pounce on them. And then these 4 men who were lepers realized something. That man, we are in a difficult situation. What do we do? Because we cannot get food. We cannot mingle with people. We cannot go to... I don't know if I'm speaking to somebody. Praise the name of the Lord. So these people were left to die. Now they were faced with 3 situations that they are talking about. Now, situation number one. Option number one. Go back to the city and die. Listen to what they're saying themselves. They're saying this. Why are we sitting here until we die? If we say, let us enter the city, the famine is in the city, and we shall die. 4 leprous men, they're saying to themselves, why do we sit here? We have been here since we were born. We have been here since our childhood. But even where we are not enjoying anything. We are only suffering. What option do we take? Let's go back to they would be stoned to death. They say, why do we sit here? Let's go back to the city. But no, we cannot go back to the city. Because if we go back to the city, even there, we are going to die. Then what do we do? Let's sit here. And then they said, no. And even if we sit here, what is going to happen? We are still going to die. If famine doesn't kill them, then there is definitely going to be the Arameans striking the city. They were the first people who will be the first protected. Nobody because of the enemy. They said, what do we see? The tents of... They will die. I'm only seeing death ahead of me. I'm only seeing trouble ahead of me. I'm only seeing a bad situation. Things turning from bad to worse. If I try to make one step backward, it turns from bad to worse. If I remain where I am to worse. So go to the enemy's camp. Maybe, we don't know. But maybe they may have mercy on us. Maybe they may give us food. You know, that's the best option. But even this best option that I'm trying to think about may still have trouble. But I want to take a risk. You know, I don't know how it's going to task God with this option and just see if the option, if they would go into the nation. That man must have been a man of faith to sound like the chariots of war, and everybody in the camp of the enemy started running. They started running, and when they got there, hey, to their surprise, thank you, ma'am. To their surprise, they found that there was nobody in the camp. And the Bible says they went in majestically. They forgot about their situation. They forgot about they were leprous. They forgot about they were rejected. They forgot about everything, because that day, it was their day. Though they had been tormented for a very long time, they had been tortured for a very long time, they said. said, we are going. They got in. They got food. They ate. They ate. They celebrated. They celebrated. They celebrated. They celebrated. They celebrated. And they started taking some. They said, of the army of the Lord. Watching. He has been watching how you have been suffering. He has been watching how you have been despised. He has been watching how they have rejected you. In my heart, they said, I will never get a child, never get married. I'm now having a beautiful wife, a beautiful husband.